Please switch off your mobile phones. Sri Krishna, Sri Krishna, Sri Krishna, Sri Krishna. Gurur Brahma, Gurur Vishnu, Gurur Devo Maheshwaraha, Guru Sakshat Param Brahma, Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha, Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha. When the seeker is like Nachiket, you all have studied Kathopanishad. Nachiket is the ideal seeker. That is the purpose why in the first chapter and first valli of Kathopanishad, the character of Nachiket was described. And he comes to ask the ultimate question to his guru, Yamaraj, that anyatra dharmat, anyatra adharmat, anyatra asmat, kruta krutat, anyatra bhutaccha bhavyaccha, yattat pashyasi tadvada. Three things he mentions. Please tell me that which is beyond the limitations of dharma and adharma. Normally, we are lost only in religion, dharma, adharma. If you do this thing, this is bad. If you do this thing, this is good. Vidhi nisheda. Do's and don'ts, they govern our life. And that alone becomes everything for us. Because we have taken this world to be very real, and we have taken ourselves to be the body. For such people, the first portion is important. Dharma Shastra. Now, these Dharma Shastra people, they are only lost this, nothing beyond it. Like when we go to so many places, in one place, one elderly gentleman told me, Swamiji, please talk about, these days the girls are cutting their hair, it is not according to our religion. So what I should do? Close all the saloons. No, if you tell, it will have impact. I say, look here, that religion which gets destroyed because of hair cutting, wo bal bal bachega. See? What has to do with the hair cutting and religion? But we get lost only in that. Girls should not put on pant. They should put on only saris. You can put on pant. You don't put on dhoti. That is okay. See, friends. Therefore, this dharma, adharma, it has a limit. Don't get lost in that. Then comes the second thing is the logic. A person gets lost in logic. So he says, anyatra asmat kruta krutat. Kruta is effect. And akruta is cause, uncreated and created. So tell me that which is beyond the scope and limitations of cause and effect. Because of this, this is happening. Because of that, that is happening. Enough of this bluff. Enough. Don't tell me that. You are suffering in this life because in the last life you have tortured her and she was doing the Karva Chauth, and therefore this life she has come to take the revenge. Now where will you run away? Cause and effect. Then the third place where we go, we are all the time wasting our time and energy only on yoga, yoga, yoga. And what is the goal that we are seeking in yoga? Is only two things, health and long life. Healthy, long life people are a problem for the society. See? No, but our Upanishad says, Kurvan neveha karmani jiji visheshatakam sama. One should live in this world doing karma and live with a view to live for 100 years. That is not the meaning, Maharaj. There is a convenient meaning we are drawn from it. The real meaning is live every moment 100%. That is the meaning. More than how many years you live, how much life you add to every year that you live is important. So, Nachiket says, don't tell me all this thing. Then, anyatra bhutaccha bhavyaccha, that which is beyond the scope of the limitations of time. If you do this thing, after death you will go to heaven. If you do this thing, you will go to hell. If you do this thing, thereafter you will get realized. There is no posthumous. We want now and here. Yat tat pashyasi tad vada. What is your right now experience? That you give me. See. For such a student, the meaning of upasana is different. Upasana for the average people is for fulfilling our desires. See, we tried our best with our efforts, we could not get it. Then we tried to approach the ministers, we could not get it. Then we tried to get a certificate of scheduled caste, scheduled tribe so that we can get it, that also we could not get it. And when we failed everywhere, then we go to the temple. Hanumanji, if I pass this examination, one coconut, guarantee. See, all our upasana is only meant for fulfilling our desires. See? But the real purpose of upasana is not that. The real purpose of upasana is we are making ourselves qualified to inquire. See? And this inquiry will not come from outside. Bubbles out within you. If you are exposed to the divine, what you get is not from the books. See? The other day one person asked me, Swamiji, sometimes you say don't think, sometimes you say that chant the Lord's name, what it is? I said, you find out, everything I will not tell. No, please tell. Now be attentive. Thinking and thought, what is the difference? Have you thought over it? See, I want a cup of tea is a thought. Sri Ram, Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram is a thought. See, so I want a cup of tea, it is a sin. And Sri Ram, Jai Ram is a merit. What is this funny thing? See, friends. Thinking is a flow of thoughts. And that flow of thought gathers a momentum. And that momentum carries us away. So, we have to have thoughts which will not create a momentum. Otherwise, we'll go to sleep. So, when you take any theme, I have to go to see the Sardar Patel, unity statue. How can I go there? Whom should I catch hold of? And how much time? One after another thought is born. When the thought breeding process is initiated, that is called as thinking. And the thinking is mostly about the future. And about the past, it is only the memory. See? Now, instead of this, if you chant the Lord's name, which is also a thought, but chanting the Lord's name does not lead to thinking. Sri Ram, Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram, over. Hari Ananta, Hari Katha Ananta. When the infinite becomes the object of thought, the thought stops. And therefore, in our scriptures, it is told that you should chant the Lord's name every day. But then where should be the effect of that chanting should be seen? The effect should be seen on the mind. So presently our condition is we are frustrated only because of our own mind. See, in old age, everything is perfectly all right. Health is good, children are settled, there is no worry, there is no nothing, money is there, respect is there, and yet the mind is disturbed. Therefore, what is required to be done? First, understand. We have to arrest the thought flow. And this thought flow is arrested like the speed breakers. When the road is straight and well protected, no possibility of any animal coming halfway. So we go on driving steady, nothing to look around. Then it leads to drowsiness, lullaby, and likelihood of accident. So in between there are speed breakers. So the moment the speed breaker comes, I give me, okay, I'm still not sleeping. Exactly. Keep on thinking. The moment you discover that you are unnecessarily thinking, thing, immediately add a speed breaker. Sri Ram, Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram, Sri Ram. And to start the chanting the Lord's name, you don't require any muhurt. See, friends, the idea is the flow of thought is arrested. See, how much we keep on thinking unnecessarily. And once you arrest the thought flow to some extent, then only we can take the next step. Then the next step is, now start playing. With your breathing, take any small name of the Lord. Hari Om, Hari Om. Sri Ram, Sri Ram, Sri Krishna, Sri Krishna. That will slowly smoothen and quieten our mind without much difficulty. After this is done, then you start inquiry. The inquiry is about four things. Who am I? What is this world? Who is God? And what is the spiritual practice? So we start with the upasana, who is God? And then we are told, if we are not able to focus our attention on the self, then we are given some vigraha, do the puja, do this what you call Sri Chakra Upasana. See, I have also taken one Sri Vidya Diksha. And then my friend told me, Swamiji, now you have to do each mantra. There are 16, 17 mantras. You have to do the Homa with so many lakhs of mantra japa. And then there has to be Udyapan giving. I said, look here, I can't do all this. What you have to do? I said, I'll not listen to you. I'll ask the one who gave me this. So I asked that Mahatmaji. I said, hey, this is what he is telling. No, 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 you don't have to do that. This is for these people. You don't have to do. What you are doing is ultimate. See? Engage yourself only in inquiry. But this is not for every Tom, Dick and Harry. The one who is sufficiently, intelligently, naturally, effortlessly withdrawn from the world. He has to do anything in this world. He is not qualified for inquiry. Anything, good or bad. Therefore, when we thus do this upasana, we chant the Lord's name so that the mind becomes quieter and quieter. And then we were told that, what is the upasana now? The first thing it is said, Shama Bodhadibi Pushpaihi Deva Atma Yadarjate. Now start doing the worship of God that you are. Worshipping the God that we are means recognize. And to recognize that, all the coverings are to be removed. See, it's a very subtle understanding. Colors and forms, they cover the vision. The sense organs cover the mind. The mind covers the intellect. The intellect covers the chetana, the life. The life covers the infinite potentiality called as kundalini shakti. And this kundalini shakti covers the absolute truth. So these are the things to be removed one by one. Objects, then sense organs, then the mind, then the intellect, then the life, then the kundalini shakti. And when these things are done, the seventh one is the Paramatma. These are the seven chakras. See, friends. And this has to be done systematically, methodically. With what we have to do this, we have to practice this with our mind. All the spiritual practice or the worldly life is lived only by the mind. Body doesn't do anything. See, like the spoon is just a means. The hand is required along with the spoon. Exactly. Behind the body, behind the sense organs, behind the hands, etc., the mind is required. So it is the mind that is the functional instrument. And therefore, here we are told that now you start working with the mind to uncover all the coverings. So the uncovering begins first. Therefore, how to do this puja? It is said that by the puja offering, the pushpa, the flowers, etc., shama bodhadvi pushpaihi. First, learn to remain quiet in this world. We don't have to get involved with anything or anybody. We don't have to get involved with relations and possessions. Everything is okay, okay. Important thing is the quality of our mind. When the value of the quiet mind is understood, then you will require no efforts. Like when we have understood the value of money, nobody complains that money earning is difficult, therefore I am not going to earn money. On the contrary, we discover new techniques. Above the table, below the table, around the table, behind the table, beyond office hours. See? Because we have value for money. Exactly the same way. When we will have value for peace of mind, your sadhana will start happening. See, my friends, then we don't have to do anything. Then you don't have to do chitta vritti nirodha. It will start happening naturally. So, thereafter, how the whole life is created was told yesterday. Desha kaladi shakti nam ullase kalita balat kramat jivo bhutva vatyashu buddhi paschad aham tataha manastvam samupayata samsaram avalambate. Thereafter, with this body identification, we start imagining the things, and this imagination, sankalpa matrenam, yaditam dukkham agatam. And because of our own thinking, we are buried in the miseries. Therefore, tataha asankalpa matrena kshiyate natra samshaya. Therefore, first we have to understand this principle. Unless we arrest this habitual thinking, there are two types of thoughts. One type of thought is the thought born out of desire. I want this, I want to do that, I want to go here. That is the thought born out of desire. Second type of thoughts are called as manorajya or habitual thinking. One old man in Bombay, he asked me this question. He said, Swamiji, please don't quote my example and don't make fun of me. I said, I will not tell your name. Example I got, I'll tell. And the question was, Swamiji, don't laugh. I said, no, go, Baba, I will not laugh. You don't require. Then he said, now I am 80. I said, what is there to laugh? No, the question is, last few days, I am remembering one girl who was our next door. That time we were in the undivided India, and her name was Kalpana, and we used to go to the school together. Where that girl is? This is troubling me a lot. Now imagine. See, where we get lost? Now he was so frustrated because of that. What I should do? I said, I'll tell you. What? She died. Really? Yes. Over. This is called a manorajya, habitual thinking. See, the habitual thinking is called daydreaming. We all are the victims of that daydreaming. Bhagavan Shankaracharya gives the example of manorajya. One young brahmachari was studying on the banks of Ganges, on the tree which was on the Ganges. So everything was over. He took his Sanskrit book. Dukrum karne, nahi nahi rakshati, dukrum karne, he was studying. And he saw during daytime, one young girl and her mother came for taking bath in the Ganges and washing the clothes and utensils. And he was sitting on the tree like a monkey and observing like a CCTV. And when he was observing that, a thought passed in his mind. Oh, that old lady, his mother, is too big. But you know, that young girl is very good. I think she's fit for me to get married. And when we get married, we'll have a nice child. In no time, the child is produced. And then when we'll be sleeping, there will be one bed. And where we'll keep the child? I think we'll keep the child in between. One side she, one side me, and the center the child. And I know she will push me, that you are crushing the child, get away. And she will push and he falls in the river. Waking. See, friends, this is called as manorajya. We keep on imagining and it becomes our second nature. Therefore, I was telling you this simple technique. Learn to stop talking to yourself. Spend some time on this. Every day, start with 10 seconds, 20 seconds. In a day, 10 times. So when you do every time 10 seconds, and you do for 10 times 100 seconds, you already achieved. Slowly do it. When this is done, then Swasankalpana kalushya nivarya jatmanaha param prasadam asadya. And when this habitual thinking is arrested, then prasadam asadya, you will attain peace. And this peace, ashantasya kuta sukham. A person who is disturbed, how can he be happy? So if you are at peace with yourself, you are happy. Therefore, start pretending that you are happy. If somebody asks you, Guptaji, how are you? Don't tell the truth. Fire, I am on the top of the world. Start practicing happiness. Again and again, repeat this. Because somebody has made a mistake. Guptaji, how are you? Kya batao yaar, baitho. Ramayana shuru. Never talk your miseries to anybody in this world. World is sufficient with their own miseries. But whenever we get somebody, pakdo or batao. No. Therefore, sarva shakti mayo hyatma sarva asadati alam Esha devaha parashtya esha pujya eva sadasatam. Therefore, sarva shakti mayo atma. And for this, you have to invoke your own potentiality. See, insist, I am not going to talk. But the mind doesn't want to die. So the mind will start popping up thoughts. See, simply sitting, what is going to happen? Instead of that, I should do the japa. Sri Ram, Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram, Sri Ram, Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram. Jai Ram bhai has taken money but never returned. I don't know how these people are. Sri Ram, Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram, Sri Ram, Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram. See, one after another, mind will dissolve if there are no thoughts. And thoughts are of three types. Memories pertaining to past, worries pertaining to future, and comparisons pertaining to present. Avoid these three things. See, these memories are like undigested food in the stomach. It comes out as a vomit. You just observe this. Anywhere anybody is talking, the third person comes and he wants to get involved in that discussion. हाँ किसके बारे में बात हो रही थी? हाँ आपके बारे में. क्या? कि आप क्यों परेशान करते हो सबको? See friends, this has become our second nature. The second thing is we keep on talking about the past. Anywhere anything happens, we have the past memories. See, there was one old lady many years before. But you are also telling past. Yes, I tell you past, but I have learned from that. When you learn from your past experiences, it is not a memory, it is the wisdom. Wisdom is light. We were having some satsanga and after the third day or so, one girl came to meet me. And we were sitting on a jhula. So she said, Swamiji, I have come to thank you. I said, okay. No, you have really changed my life. I said, I'm so sorry. No, it is a good thing you have done. What I have done? She said, I came with a view to get divorce from my husband. But after listening to your satsanga, I have decided I should not. I understood the whole consequences of that. Thank you very much for protecting me. I said, anyway, good. Now, don't try again. Then she said, I want to ask one or two questions. I said, okay, ask. And then she started asking. One question she asked. The moment she asked the question, this old lady who was sitting with me, she replied. She was not asked. Then, second question she asked. Again she replied. Then third time, when she wanted to vomit, then the girl said, excuse me, I have not come talk to you, okay? Let Swamiji talk. Then I told her, look here, I only told Amma, she has got such a great experience, she can tell. Anyway, I'll tell you now. Amma, go and get a cup of tea for me, I sent her. And afterwards, then she started crying. I mean, everybody does like this with me, you know. Whenever I talk, they say, don't talk. What is wrong? See, friends, it is only because as the age grows, we have gone through so many good and bad experiences, and those experiences can be comparable with anybody's experience in the world. And suddenly we go back. Accident, education, frustration, friends, enemies, health, disease, any topic you take, we all have gone through that. And again we bring it out. This is how the mind survives. See, friends. Therefore, this ashanta, the sankalpana kalushyam nivarya, this kalusha, the impurity of the mind is this. All the time either talking about the past or worrying about the future or comparing in the present. Then prasadam asadhya paramanandavan bhava. And this is possible by sarva shakti mayo atma. You don't have to depend outside anywhere. You can do it. Esha Devaha Parascha Eva Esha. This is what is God. Somewhere in Maharashtra, once I was going to a mountain, Mahur, where the Renuka Devi's temple is there. Parashuramji has killed his mother there. So that head temple is there. Through the deep forest we have to go. On the way, there is a small temple. And we stopped there for a cup of tea. And then we went inside to see the temple. All dilapidated. There are many scorpions and snakes. So we had to carefully go, take darshan Lord Shiva, and came out. That time, we saw one board. The name of the temple was Mandev Temple. So my friend asked, what is this Mandev? What is this Mandev? I said, it is Mana, mind is the God. Don't seek God outside. If you are at peace with yourself, you are one with the God, without death. This is the most important, valuable thing in our life. Keep cool. How important it is. But we are constantly agitated. So, dhyana, then pujanam dhyanam eva antaha nanyad astyasya pujanam. Therefore, how to do the puja of this Atma, the Self, the God, is dhyanam eva anta. Now remain aware again and again. Are we disturbed? Are we reacting? Are we evaluating? Getting involved? And the most, and all these things can be put together by one technique. Just ask a question to yourself. Is it necessary to talk? You don't have to practice a maunam thereafter. But that doesn't mean that, see, people will say that I am very egoistic and how to live. No, you talk in the public, but talk such topics which will create no merit or no sin. For example, today's weather is very good. This will not create sin or merit. And say anything. See, it is so hot in last 30-100 years. Never such a terrible heat has born. Who is going to check it? Say something. Just time pass. But nothing very special, nothing very serious. Then, when this we start doing, Chidrupam Suru Lakshabham Samastha Vasa Vasanam, then we come to know that the same reality alone is expressing through everything and being. Now be attentive. All the colors and forms illuminated by one vision. All the sense organs illuminated by one mind. All the minds are expressions of one consciousness or one life or chetana. And all the chetana is the expression of one shakti, infinite shakti, individually called as kundalini and collectively called as the maya avyakta namni paramesha shakti. And the same reality is expressing through everything and being. See, the one who has come to this experience, for him, when somebody is hungry, sharing food with him or her is natural for him. Because, be attentive, because the pangs of hunger are common for everyone, whether it is a rich man or it is a pig on the roadside. The pangs of hunger are same, and the satisfaction of hunger is also the same. See, friends, this is what is called as Sarvatma Anubhuti. One has merged with the totality. And in this manner, when we come to discover Swasamvidatma Devoyam no upaharena pujyate, then he is not worshipped by the flowers and giving naivedya, etc. Then nityam aklesha labhena bodhena svena pujyate. Without any aklesha means without any efforts, only remaining aware about our being. That is the highest worship. See, friends, the more we remain intensely aware of our being, the more we are relaxed. There is no tension. See, as you go closer to yourself, you will see efforts are minimum. If you go away from yourself, you end up in ignorance. You are knowledge. When you go away, you end up in ignorance. Therefore, when we thus remain more and more in awareness, then nityam aklesham labhena bodhena svena pujyate, then we are really following the upasana, the puja. Now, bahya sampujanam proktam. Now, we have already told you the external puja. Now, we tell you the internal puja. Nityameva sharirastam imam dhyayet param shivam svadehe savidabhaso devoyam iti bhavayet. Now, hereafter, this Paramatma, again and again, do this bhavana, be attentive. I am body is only a bhavana. I am a husband or wife is a bhavana. I am mother or father is a bhavana. It is not the reality. So if we can do this bhavana, why not do this bhavana that I am divine? What can justify to say that I am the body? Nothing. Because body is not created by us, nor the body listens to us. And yet we are imagining that I am the body. So if we have to imagine, and if we are expert in imagining, why don't you imagine I am divine? But don't tell others. See, friends, this story I had told, two children were playing mummy and the husband wife. So the wife gives to the husband, take yesterday's leftover vegetable and the bread. So the husband brother says, see, you are not giving me anything, only imagining. Yes, because we are playing. Then if you are playing and only imagining, why don't you imagine? Take jalebi and rasgulla. Imagine it to karna hai na. So I am body is imagination. I am unhappy imagination. I am unfortunate imagination. I am successful imagination. I am beautiful. Imagination. See, friends? So if we are so expert in imagining, why don't we imagine? That is called as bhavana. And this bhavana was the mainstay of Bhagavan Ramakrishna Paramahamsa. See? His whole spiritual practice was only bhavana. When he was doing the bhavana, the Hanumat Upasana, that time he used to leave the dhoti from backside like a tail and he used to jump and walk. He became one with that. See? Therefore, nityameva sharirastam imam dhyayet param shivam svadehe samvidabhaso devoyam iti bhavayet. So this awareness is the Paramatma. Keep on holding on to this thought. See? If you take a mirror and keep a candle in front of the mirror, there will be reflection. But if you bring that candle nearer, nearer to the mirror to such an extent that it is almost touching, what will happen as a result? The mercury oxide, which is on the back side of the mirror, will be slowly melted away because of the heat of the flame. And after that is melted out, the reflection will disappear. Exactly the same way. When I, the seeker, whosoever he may be, when we go on doing this bhavana, it is like bringing the light of the mind nearer to the light of the consciousness, and there the light of the mind dissolves in the consciousness. See, in a dark room, candlelight is very bright. The same candlelight, when it is brought in the sunlight, 12 o'clock, it becomes insignificant because the sunlight is overpowering. Now the sun is illuminated by which light? By our eyes. So the light of our eyes is more powerful than the sunlight. Then the eyes of the light is illuminated by which light? By the mind's light. So the light of the mind is much more powerful than the sunlight and eyes light. Go subjectively. And when this light of the mind is focused to the source, this mind's light becomes insignificant and only the truth remains. That is the meaning of doing bhavana. See, friends. So dehe sva samvid amaso devo yambidhi bhavayen. Then, while doing this bhavana, nashtam nashtam upekshetha praptam praptam upahare nirvikarataya etadhi parama paramarchana atmanaha. See, nashtam nashtam upekshetha praptam praptam upahare. See, there are two things that happen in our life. Something is lost, something we get. Towards both the things, learn to remain indifferent. Yes, things lost sometimes, sometimes we gain. Atitanagatap kinchit nasmarami na chintaye. Whatever has gone. What is going to come, let it come. Learn to remain indifferent. Therefore, nashtam nashtam upekshetha. See, here the word sakshi is not used. Upekshetha means be indifferent. It happens. Everybody gets sometime good, sometime bad. And then nirvikarataya etadhi. Meaning, let gain and loss lead to no impact on the mind. Now the same thing, go back to Bhagavad Gita. Sukha dukkhe same krutva labha labho jaya jayo tato yuddhaya yujyasva naivam papam avapsasi. Whenever we do anything in life, either there is a gain or a loss, or victory or a defeat, or joy or sorrows. Same krutva, remain equanimous. Keeping the equanimity intact is freedom from sin and merit. Naivam papam avapsasi. Meaning, live in this world in such a manner that no impressions are allowed to be precipitated on our mind. Let our mind be like the mirror. Mirror doesn't reject anyone and doesn't retain anyone. Mirror doesn't have history. Mirror doesn't have the memory. Mirror doesn't have the personality. Mirror doesn't have the ego. Let our mind be maintained to that quality. What is that kind of mind? Be attentive. That kind of mind is 100% in the present. Mirror doesn't have the past. Mirror doesn't have the future. Mirror is always in the present. Simply listening this, don't you feel quite a different experience? Simply listening. See? The other day, somebody asked me in Bombay or Bangalore, Swamiji, you have gone so many places. Which is the car that you like the best? I said, Tesla. You sat in that car? See? Now when such a good car, somebody's using, you feel very good. If you have that car, simply listening to this is so joyful. If it remains your natural state, that is called a Jivan Mukti. See, my friends, therefore, sarvam brahmeti nishchitya nityatmarchanam vratam charet Atma Archana Vidhanena Asmin Prokta Dravesh Shriyastuyaha Ete Neiva Shame Naita Rasena Paribhavita. So, this is one thing, take care of your mind. Now the second thing, inner sadhana, sarvam brahmeti nishchitya. It's not that I am only Brahman, but everything is Brahman. Now be attentive. Two things happen. When we take this world as an illusion, and when we take this world as Brahma Paramatma, both of them lead to the same conclusion. When we take this world as an illusion, we never desire illusions. We enjoy illusions. We don't desire. See? And the second thing, when we accept the world as ourself, we never desire ourselves. We desire others. Desire demands a sense of otherness. In the deep sleep, there is no sense of otherness, therefore there is no desire. So what is the net result? Whether you take this world as an illusion or you take this world as the Brahman or the reality which includes you, the net result will be we will be free from all desires. See? And all our desires are useless desires. See? Morning I wanted a cup of tea, but I could not get it. Are daridri? Be miserable for something higher. See? Get out of these wrong things in life. It's only because of dependence. See, Mahabharata writes, sarvam paravasham dukkham, sarvam atmavasham sukham, etad vidyat samasena laksharam sukha dukkha yoho. How much dependent we are on the servants, on our nears and dears, for every little thing. See? In Assam, many years before, I had to go to somebody's house for lunch, a Assami family. And first of all, I went and met that old lady. So I sat with her, talked for some time and came. Then I was sitting with the daughter-in-law and having food. I said, Mama, now I have finished my food. Now I want to tell you something. Should I tell? Yes, Swamiji. I said, you will get angry? No, no, because you will tell for my good. I said, your mother-in-law is more beautiful and younger than you. When I said like this, she says, Swamiji, I 100% agree with you. I am jealous of her. I said, what is her lifestyle? She told, she doesn't take seva from anybody. She is now almost 78, 80. She washes her clothes. She makes her bed. After the food is finished, she lifts her plate at that old age. She will wash it and keep it. Cup of tea she takes, thereafter she will keep the cup washing properly in the right place and dry it. And she doesn't take a food which is cooked for more than 4 hours. Within 4 hours, if it is, then she eats. And she takes only 2 times meal. 11 o'clock and 7 o'clock, that's it. And she takes 2-3 times tea. Her life is so disciplined. And the most important thing, she doesn't ask anybody any question. Now the grandchildren come and go. She doesn't ask, where you are gone, what is you are studying? No, a child, Sukiro, be happy. Doesn't get involved with anything or anybody. The net result is, she is at peace. A person who is at peace can be distinctly seen from his eyes. See, friends. Therefore, sarvam brahmeti nishchitya, there cannot be any burden of desires on our mind. Ete neiva shame neta. Now this kind of puja is ete neiva shamena. Thus, keep the mind at peace under all conditions. This is called as the inner spiritual practice or inner puja of the God. Then for this, the teacher says, Shastrarthaihi buddhyate natma guru vachanato nacha buddhyate svayamevaisha svabodavashata svataha. Shastrartha buddhyate natma. By studying the scriptures, you will never know the truth. Kathopanishad says that na pravachanena labhya. By listening to the pravachan, by giving the pravachan, na medhaya, na bahuna shrutena, nor by remembering all the mantras and listening to every kind of mahatma, na labhyaha. Then, yamai vesha vrunute te na labhyaha. He who is seeking the truth to the exclusion of everything, to him the truth is revealed. The truth reveals. Bhaye prakata krupala dina dayala. See, that is what is to be understood. Let the Lord manifest through us. Don't seek him. He is suffocating inside. And he can manifest if only we remove the unwanted curtains, coverings. See, importance to the worldly objects, one covering. Importance to the sense organs, second covering. Importance to the activities, third covering. There is no end to that. Discard all of them and let him express. The only purpose of our life is that we remain such an ideal instrument that he will choose us for his job. We have no purpose in our life. Purpose he has. See, if we have to do something, are we not searching for a right kind of person to get our job done? If we are searching for a right kind of person, will he not choose a right kind of person to get his job done? And who will be right kind of person? Like this mic. This is the right kind of mic because it is not making his own noise. Sometimes the mics make their own noise. Sometimes there is electronic omkar, hum. Sometimes it will start clearing its own throat, kar, 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 kar. Then we throw it away. Exactly the same way, let him express through us. An expression of the divinity through us is only happiness. See, friends, therefore, be happy or moj me raho is not an ordinary thing. But many people think, you know, Swamiji, what is this, your logo, simply be happy. Normally, logos are complicated. See, there will be some snake, there will be sunrise, there will be birds, and there will be a lamp, and there will be, you know, ocean, and then sunrise. And then they have to explain what is the meaning of all that. I said, my logo doesn't require any explanation. Logo, logon ke liye hai. And be happy, what is there to understand? Those who think, they cannot laugh. Those who laugh, they don't think. How simple it is. But start thinking, what is the meaning of this logo? Oh, that snake is, you know, it will bite you. Oh, go. Useless. Let happiness express through us under all conditions. And happiness means what? Living at zero complaint level. Happiness doesn't mean somebody has fallen, gir gaya. That is not happiness. See, friends, it's foolishness. Therefore, esha eva shameneta rasena paribhavitaha shastradhari buddhyate natma. Not by studying the scriptures, na guru vachanato, nor by the words of guru. Because guru is always telling us that you are Brahman. Ah, ka Brahman. See, he may tell us, but are we ready to accept it? Bhagwan Krishna, we call out of courtesy. Krishnam Vande Jagat Guru. If he was a Jagat Guru, why he failed to teach Duryodhan, Dushyasan, Dhritarashtra? See, like we have got every corner Shankaracharya. Kitne, dozens of them. See, friends. Therefore, then, buddhyate svayameva esha. You have to discover yourself. Nobody can help you. And so bodha vashataha, by your own experience, you will be able to discover. Now it will appear as if the Vasistha ji is condemning the scriptures and the guru. Now the teacher says, guru upadesha shastrathaihi vina atma na buddhate. Unless you submit yourself to the study of scriptures and the guidance by the guru, etat sayogat eva. So both the things are required. We study the scriptures, go to the teacher, tad vidyanartham guru meva vigachet, samit panhi shrotriyam brahmanishtam, and also put efforts. It is not guru maharaj uthao, mule guru or what? See, Vivek Chudamani end clearly tells, after having given all the knowledge, thereafter, the guru went his way, the disciple went his way. There is no holding on to. See, friends. Therefore, esha devarchanam nityam yakkaroti samahitaha yatra asmat adayo bhrutya tata eva yati parampadam. In this manner, he who is doing the devarchana, the puja of the God, which is in his own heart. Yaha karoti samahitaha, with proper understanding and complete withdrawal, he who is thus worshipping the divine that he is by the technique we have discussed so far, then yatra asmadayaha mrutyaha tata eva. This is told by Lord Shiva to Vasistha ji. Vasistha ji is telling to Bhagwan Rama. So here it is said that this person who has thus attained this and discovered the divinity, then we are also the servants of such a great master. Shivaji says. See? Because now there is no question of separateness. There is only one reality. And iktitva nilakanthosau antardhanam kshanadgataha tata prabhruttin teneva kramedarchanam atmanaha adyayavan gatavyagraha kurvan aham avasthitaha. This having told by Nilakantha, by Lord Shiva to Vasistha ji, Vasistha ji was telling the story. He was doing his puja archana on the Ganges bank, and Lord Shiva came and he did his puja archa, and he asked how to do the correct type of puja archa. Then this all was told, and after that was told by Shiva to Vasistha ji, then Shivji antardhan, he disappeared in nowhere, no place. And thereafter, what has Vasistha ji done? Be attentive. Tataha prabhruti tenaiva kramena archana atmanaha. Thereafter, I started practicing this as my upasana, my puja, according to the technique given. So what will be the our now spiritual practice? See, number one, highest achievement is peace of mind. Number two, don't get involved in the worldly things. Number three, before we talk to others, ask a question to yourself. Is it necessary to talk? Number four, do Kamod Yoga. Don't talk to yourself. Practice slowly. Don't get involved. When you are carried away by some theme, immediately start firing. Sri Ram, Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram, Sri Ram, Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram. That speed of thought will be arrested. All these things that we have discussed, again and again, when you try, the goal will be, you are not a problem to yourself. Because you have disappeared. Now the Lord has taken over. So, Tataha Prabhuti Tineva Krameda Archanam Atmanaha Adyayavad Gatavyagraha Kurvan Aham Avastitaha. So I have been from that day onward till now, this is all the spiritual practice I am doing, and while doing this thing, what is my attitude? The teacher says, Anena Archa Vidhanena Maya Ime Rama Vasaraha Akhinna Eva Ativayante Vivahara Parapi. Thus, with this technique, I am living for time pass. When I tell you the Sanskrit into English, you will not accept it. But it's the same thing if I tell you in Sanskrit, then it is true. See, friends, the real spiritual practice is time pass. This is what you are doing now. And me too. Whenever you are serious about anything, you are lost. When you do things lightly, thode gam hai, thode khushiya. Yes, sometime we'll win, sometime we'll lose. It happens. What is great about it? See? If everybody passes, who will fail? Somebody has to fail. See? So, anena archana vidhanena maya ime vasaraha. Vasara means my days. This is how I am passing my days. Meaning, he is not achieving anything. Be attentive. You don't have to achieve anything in life. You are that. Like the husband doesn't have to achieve the man. He is a man. Only thing, he was covered by the burden of the wife. And therefore, he forgot his divinity, the manhood. See? One lady went to the office late, and her boss was also a lady. So the lady who came late, the boss asked, why are you late? The lady complained, see the wonderful complaint. She said, I was talking to my husband, but he kept listening. So I have to talk. How simple it is. Make life a fun. We are all here only on a vacation. This is not our home. Like I come here in Ahmedabad, I stay with Niruben. Now I know that is not my house. So I enjoy, they suffer. I enjoy. And then I leave all the mess behind and get away. Another house. New drivers, new chauffeurs, new car, new place. See? When I know that I have to leave this place, I will not create either friends or enemies. Go through, that's it. See, friends, and this is the truth, whether we want or we don't want. We are in this world on a vacation. This is not our house. So what is the technique I follow? Countdown. When I came here, I started with 4. 4, 3, 2, 1. Tomorrow morning I am going. As much I am happy, 100 times they are happy. Thank God. So only happiness everywhere. See, this is how, if you lead your life, you will never, never be miserable. So, akhinna ativayante. Without akhinna, khinna means miserable. Akhinnena. Only cheerfully, happily, time pass. Vyavahara parapi. That doesn't mean I am not engaged in something creative. I am, but I am relaxed. Then, Ayane anayaya eva sadrushtyam sangha muktena chetasa samsara viralaranye vihara asminna kidyase. Now, after having told all this thing, now Bhagwan Rama is advised by Vasishtha ji. anaya evacha sadrishtya. Now by this vision, and take this vision as the ultimate vision, sadrishtya, sangha muktena chetasa. Let your mind not get entangled, attached to anything or anybody. To get out of attachment, there is only one way, the wise way. And the wise way is, attachment is an illusion. There is no attachment. Just observe this world. The rule is, illuminator is never attached to what is illumined. Like the light. The light is not attached to the me or to the audience or to the furniture. If there are more people, it makes no difference to the light. If there is nobody, it makes no difference to the light. This is the gross light. Now come to the light of your eyes. Whether you are 200 or you are 5,000, it makes no difference to my eyes. See, similarly, whether there are good thoughts or bad thoughts, it makes no difference to my mind. Similarly, whether it's a waking dream, deep sleep or samadhi, it makes no difference to me, the pure consciousness. Even to our body, we are not attached. What is sleep? Sleep is detachment from body, is sleep. See? So this wrong notion that we carry, that I cannot live without this, without that. They remove this wrong notion. We are not attached to anything. See, friend, this is what is meant here. Anaya eva sadrushtya sangha muktena chetasa. And this can happen only through wisdom, not by anything. See, samsara viralarande vihar asmin na khidyase. So in this forest of samsara viraha vihara, keep on moving in this world and na khidyase, and never become miserable. Meaning, be happy. See? It is because of this. Although, when Bhagwan Ram was offered the position that he will be the crown prince, and the next day he was told, no, you have to go to forest. Both the things kept him cool. Because he was initiated to this knowledge before he got into the world. See, friends. But for us, is it too late? No, it is too early for the next life. It is not late. On the spiritual path, you are never late. It is not a time-bound scheme. Any time you start with all sincerity. See? Vidyaranya Swami wrote Panchadashi at the age of 70. Not when he was young. See, friends. Therefore, age is not a criteria. Don't worry about it. Oh, so much time I have wasted, I have never done anything. Now what will happen? Don't worry. Nobody is interested in our past. Remember this principle. See? And when you are talking or worrying about the past, in short, what is unknowingly happening, that you are not ready to give your body identification. And therefore you are talking about your past. If this practice you take as spiritual practice, body disidentification is the first goal on the spiritual path. And leaving the wrong notion that I am a soul in a body, this second wrong notion, when it is discarded, then alone the truth is revealed. It is for this purpose. Number one, body disidentification. Number two, giving up the notion that I am a soul in the body. If these two things are aimed at, worked for, then we are walking the spiritual path. Otherwise, kurute ganga sagara gamanam vrata paripalanam athavadanam. Agre vanni prushte bhanu ratro chubuka samarpita janu. Jatilo mundi lunchita kesha kasha yambara bahukrita vesha. This has nothing to do with the reality. Only these two things. Again and again work on these two principles. What does it mean to be other than the body? And who is this other than the body? The jiva. Then what is the jiva? When these two things are worked upon, we are walking the spiritual path. Otherwise, punarapi jananam, punarapi maranam. Continue. Tabla peti, nothing is going to help. Om Purnamadaha Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti 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 Harihi Om Sri Gurubhyo Namaha Harihi Om.